right now I'm in Behraj, which of course has seen wolf attacks over a span of at least a couple of 2 or 3 months or so. This actually started in the month of March and has been continuing throughout. In fact, just last night there was an attack which in fact I was witness to. The child was immediately rushed to the hospital. But before I talk to you about that attack that took place last night, a sense of where I am right now. I'm going to ask Sanjay now to just pan and show you what's going on right now. Now, this is another village in this particular district, and this is the swollen Ghagra River that you see right now on your screens. The swollen Ghagra River, which has led to displacement of wolves, one of the reasons why experts think that they have become stressed and that they have become aggressive. That's one of the reasons. Wolf sightings and attacks have become extremely common. We've been speaking to villagers who have in fact spoken about the fact that wolves are being spotted on a regular basis in many places. I told you about last night. What actually happened was that a 10-year-old child was at home, and this not late in the night, not in the wee hours of the morning. This was at 8 p.m. in the evening, late evening essentially, wherein this child came under attack once. He just stepped out for a second out of the house. Now, the blessing here was that the child was not exactly an infant. It was a 10-year-old, and the child screamed, shouted, alerting the family members who came running out, scaring the animal and running away. But this is the ordeal of 10-year-old Sangam, who in fact has now been attacked and is recuperating in a district hospital in Behraj. Take a look at this report. This is night patrolling being done on a tractor where I am right now. All these people are villagers, the volunteers, they're helping out. They've been involved by the forest department, have been told that you have to get onto a tractor and let these announcements reach every nook and corner of all of these villages. On the left side of me are sugarcane fields where we see many of these wolves essentially hiding. They're able to camouflage themselves very well here. Some of these are villagers, and many of them have been in fact working with the forest department as well. Let's get a sense from them about what is going on here. Kitne der der raat tak yahan par is tarah se aap log patrolling karte hain?
Raat 9 baje se subah 5 baje tak hum log patrolling karte rehte hain.
Kitne din tak ye chalega, aapko kya lagta hai? Isse kya bhediya dar jata hai ya logo pe अवेयरनेस पहुंचती है कि वो जान जाते हैं कि इस तरीके से बाहर नहीं सोना?
आवाज आती है तो गांव वाले भी जग जाते हैं, और आवाज से भेड़िया भी डर के खेतों में भाग जाता है, इसीलिए हम लोग पेट्रोलिंग करते हैं रेडियो के साथ में.
लेकिन ये कब तक चलेगा?
ये कोई फिक्स नहीं है मैम, जब तक भेड़िया पकड़ा नहीं जाता है तब तक ये पेट्रोलिंग चलती रहेगी.
भैया आप बता रहे थे कि बिल्कुल यही इस गांव में भेड़िया दिखा?
बगल के गांव में है.
कल रात की बात
वही 9 बजे के हाल है.
तो फिर यहां पर जब भेड़िया दिख जाता है तो फिर क्या इसके बाद क्या करते हैं? गांव
बस गांव वाले लोहो लोहो के बस खेत देते हैं, तो क्या करें? कौन उपाय है उनकी? कोई उपाय उनकी नहीं है.
दो भेड़िया दिखे?
दो थे, दो, एक नहीं था, दो थे.
प्रशासन से कोई बातचीत इस बारे में?
दरोगा जी से बातचीत हुई थी तो कहें 2 मिनट पहुंच रहे हैं, इसके बाद दरोगा जी तो फिलहाल पहुंचे नहीं वहां पर.
क्या बात कर रहे हैं कि आपने फोन किया और पहुंचे
नहीं? फोन किए थे, उनके आदमी एक वहीं रहा तो वो कहे लगा कि भैया हम फोन कर रहे हैं, फोन की जू दरोगा जी कहे लगा कहीं 2 मिनट के अंदर हम पहुंचे थे. फिलहाल कोई ना आया मौके पर, कोई पहुंचे भी नहीं. कहीं
आप लोग क्या कुछ दिखाई नहीं पड़ा? दिखाई नहीं पड़ा. तमाम जो लोग, इससे आप गन से कितना दूर तक फायर कर सकते हैं?
350 मीटर.
350 मीटर. तो ये आप लोग का क्या काम दिया गया? शूटेड साइड अगर भेड़िया दिखता है तो मार देना है
जी?
आराम से नहीं सकोगे? मतलब अगर भेड़िया दिखता है तो उसको मार देना है
जी? जी जी.
तो क्या भेड़िया साइट हुआ था?
दिखाई नहीं पड़ा.
और कितना दूर तक इसकी गोली जाती है इस गन की?
350 मीटर.
तो किस तरह से आप लोगों ने घेरा था उसको भेड़िया को?
तरफ से घेरा था, लेकिन वहाँ पे थाने लोकेट हुआ घाम की वजह से, वो कैमरे में से ही आया नहीं. सीआर का बच्चा था, वही बैठा था.
अच्छा, आप लोगों ने ड्रोन में देखा सीआर का बच्चा था, आप लोगों को लगा भेड़िया है?
जी जी.
तो आप लोग पहुंच गए वहाँ पे?
पहुंच गए वहाँ पे, लगाया गया. इतनी मेहनत करने के बावजूद सीआर निकला हुआ.
और शूटर्स भी थे, शार्प शूटर आए थे?
हाँ, शार्प शूटर.
कितने शार्प शूटर आए थे?
वहाँ 5-6 लोग हैं.
रात में वही 9 बज रहा था, यहाँ दुकान के पास से गुजरा, फिर अंदर गया तो वहाँ शोर मचाया, लोग मतलब रपटाए. तो
दुकान के पास से किधर से गुजरा?
इधर से सर.
इधर से?
जी जी. और वही रात में 9 बज रहा था, फिर गांव में घुस गया तो वहाँ बकरी उकरी थी, तो वहाँ बकरी को मतलब ये कम नोचने उचने लगा. उसके बाद गांव के सब लोग थे वहाँ रपटाने लगे.
यहीं पर पास में उसकी मांद भी बनी है?
नहीं, वो चालारी घाट में मतलब उधर रेत में. जी जी सर।
अब हम लोग तो ऐसी त्रासदी से पहले तो देखा नहीं, आते थे पहले भी आते थे, बकरी वकरी अगर कहीं पा गए मौका तो बकरी वकरी लेके चले गए। एक एक अभी 2-3 महीने पहले एक बकरी को पकड़ा था, लेकिन ये जो आदमखोर वाली व्यवस्था ये पहले नहीं देखा गया था।
2 महीने पहले हमारे बच्चे को पकड़ के लेके आया था, यहाँ हम लोग छीने थे।
अच्छा, भेड़िया आपके बच्चे को उठा गया?
बच्चा सलामत है, जिंदा है।
कहाँ छोड़ा गया?
उसके यहाँ कमर में और गर्दन में, दांत वात उसके लग गए थे, फिर उसकी दवा पानी कराया, फिर जिंदा है।
Alright, this time it is Bahraich, essentially in the eastern part of Uttar Pradesh. But remember, this is the Indo-Gangetic Plains, and that has always been prone to some attacks. If not at this scale, then 1 or 2 attacks in many of these places here in Uttar Pradesh has actually not been uncommon. Let's tell you about Sultanpur in the month of January last year, where an 18-month-old child was killed by a wild wolf in Chakmusi village. In the month of March in 2020, in Lakhimpudi, a similar attack took place. But these were 21 villagers who were attacked by a pack of wild wolves. In the month of January 2019, in Alipur, a girl dragged away by a wolf, only the skull was recovered. That's also happening in many cases in Bahraich here. In December 2018, in Sambhal, a boy was dragged away by a pack of wild wolves as well. Essentially, people living in many parts of Uttar Pradesh, and also because of poverty, they're living in huts. These are kaccha makans that they're living in. We came across one such kaccha makan, and we'd heard stories of how this man was actually sitting on guard all night along with his wife. He's been doing this since the 16th of August. He's got 5 children. It's a kaccha makan that he lives in. It does not have doors. Now, guess what's the irony? The irony is that the administration here, the forest officials here, are blaring from the loudspeakers that lock up the doors of your house when you're sleeping at night. Do not sleep outside. What do such people do then? Listen in to this report. Just last night, right across that fence that you see, that broken wall that you see, 2 wolves were spotted. It's unbelievable as to how 2 wolves are roaming around together. What really is unbelievable and difficult to understand here is that the people living in this little hut here without doors spotted the wolves. Calls were made to the administration. Calls were made to the police that 2 wolves have been spotted. However, nobody came here is what the villagers are telling us. This is a family that lives in this particular hut. This man, Babu, has been sitting on guard all night with his wife. He's got small children. The others have been sent away because their house, as you can see, has got no doors. Look at this where they're staying in. This absolutely has got no doors. It's a big, big concern, given that the administration has been telling these villagers that lock your doors up. They say that we haven't slept for an hour over a period of just so many days, over 15 days or so. Given that the administration is responding in some areas, but it's very difficult to understand why they aren't in cases like these. These are people who are vulnerable, no electricity at night, no security, no protection. The wolves are on the prowl, as what the villagers are telling us. It's a huge area of concern. It's a problem that needs to be looked into on an urgent basis. All right, so yesterday I, in fact, went to the banks of the Ghagra River, where I am right now also. This, of course, is the other side of it, where the river was completely swollen up. Experts have been talking about the fact that the flooding here has led to the displacement of the wolf and the natural habitat has been tampered with. And that's the reason why they're showing some signs of aggression. Also, I met with a family whose 2-year-old baby was taken away. The half-eaten body of the baby was found earlier. I sent in these reports yesterday. Take a look at what I saw in Bahraich. This is the village which has been in news for all the wrong reasons for weeks together right now. Wolves have been attacking the people here, then compelling the authorities to arrive at the conclusion that they have turned man-eaters, because it's not one, it's not two, it's been several attacks. Children are the victims of these wolves. They're vulnerable, and wolves find them easy prey. I'm coming to you from Bahraich right now. This village, like I said, which has been in news for the wrong reasons, not just in India, but outside of India also, given that world over, there are concerns over wolves attacking animals and how this has turned into a major animal-human conflict. Right behind me, the fields of Bahraich. These are the sugarcane fields from where the wolves essentially are known to hide. Operation Bhedia is also on of the UP administration and the Forest Department, wherein they're making an effort to catch these wolves. There's been a fair amount of success, but the sad bit is that the attacks here continue and villagers continue to live in fear. क्या नाम है आपका?
हमारा नाम है उधम सिंह।
ये उधम सिंह जी, बताइए, अचानक से आप लोग के हिसाब से भेड़िया ऐसे क्यों अटैक कर रहे हैं? बच्चों के साथ, भेड़ियों के बच्चों के साथ कुछ लेना देना? आप गन्ने के बारे में भी कुछ बताए, गन्ने के खेत के बारे में भी बता रहे हैं।
गन्ने के खेत में बच्चे भाट फाट रखे, वो बच्चे जोत हो गए थे, खेत जोत ही गए। हाँ हाँ, भेड़े के बच्चे, खेत की जुताई हुई रही थी, उसके बाद वो मर गए उसी के तरफ से।
ये कब हुआ? ये कब हुआ?
गर्मी में हुआ।
दिस इज द प्लेस ऑफ 2-year-old प्रतिभा, हु वाज किल्ड ऑन द 27th ऑफ ऑगस्ट बाय अ वुल्फ, टेकन अवे फ्रॉम द फील्ड्स राइट फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर स्पॉट where the family was at about 2 or 3 in the morning is what they tell us. The wolf came exactly from this route where I am right now and dragged the child away. Just give you a sense of what the parents here are saying. These are the parents of Pratibha, the baby who was killed by the wolf. And just right here is what the parents are telling us. The wolf, every single day, even after the attack, chooses this spot. This spot, takes this particular route is what they're telling us. ये बताइए राकेश जी, उस रात क्या हुआ? आपने कहा बच्चे को सवेरे ही उठा लिया था, बहुत ही सवेरे था, 2 या 3 बजे का समय था।
जी वही 3:10 का समय था। मेरी बेटी ने पानी मांगा तो इसने घर से लेके आया, वहाँ पे बैठा दिया, फिर नल ढारने लगी, उतनी देर में दबोच के ले गया भेड़िया। फिर तुरंत हमको आवाज मिली, चिल्लाई, मैं तुरंत दौड़ा तो इस जगह पे दिखी हमको, पानी में जाता हुआ दिखा, फिर मैं दौड़ा तुरंत, लेकिन वो कुछ सीधे भगा। तो फिर मैंने घर पे आया, टार्च लेके और डंडे लेके दौड़ा तो सीधे नहीं गया, वो भाग गया था दक्षिण की तरफ पे।
This village has just so many stories. Stories of children being taken away and accountability being fixed in terms of some compensation being given to villagers, the family members who've been left behind. But this family doesn't even have the solace of that monetary compensation, of that help from the administration, of that help from the government. They lost their child, perhaps to a wolf attack. That's what they say. But because the body of the child was never found, it's not counted as a wolf attack and hence they've not been compensated. आपके बच्चे को, आपके पोती को आप कह रहे थे कि भेड़िया उठा ले गया, लेकिन कभी भी एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ने, पुलिस ने इस केस को भेड़िया अटैक का माना ही नहीं कि भेड़िया ने हमला किया।
हम भेड़िया हमला किया, कोई नहीं माना। हाँ, कोई नहीं माना।
क्यों ऐसे बोल रहे थे आपको?
नहीं माने तो कोनो पाँच भाई कोई पैसा कौड़ी दे वाला हो तो देते रहते थे, मनती और मुर्दा धुर्दार मनाए तो कहा जाए माने।
These are the kind of warnings. Jagte raho, savdhan, beware, be careful. Be careful of the fact that there is a wild animal, more than one, and that it's turned a man-eater. Do not sleep outside your houses. Do not make yourself vulnerable. Keep your children safe. Lock up the doors of the house. If you do not have doors, construct doors. These are the kind of warnings that is blaring across loudspeakers These are members, workers of the forest department. Villagers have come all together to help solve this problem, to warn the villagers, to help keep them safe. And all of them are telling us that things like these, warnings like these will continue over a period of time. Yet another wolf attack. This time it involves a 10-year-old Sangam who's been injured. Thankfully, the eyewitnesses here, the mother and the aunt of the child, saw the child, heard the child make noise, and that's when they came out running out of the house. The aunt of the child has seen the wolf attack and saw the wolf escape after the child made noise, and the woman here, the aunt, who stepped out of the house to then save the child. Ab bataiye, अब कह रही थी कि ये 8 बजे हुआ, कुछ समय पहले हुआ है, हुआ क्या, आपने क्या देखा?
अरे हम देखा जी सही हो, अरे एक जब नोचने लगी दरवाजे के पास पहुंचना, तो नोचने लगी, जब सब कोई दौड़न तो भेड़िया भाग लिया।
कितना बड़ा था भेड़िया? है आप श्योर थे कि वो भेड़िया ही था?
इतना बड़ा भेड़िया था।
फिर क्या हुआ, क्या देखा आपने? बच्चे को कितना चोट लगा हुआ था?
बच्चा के लिए है, गाल में लगी है, ऐसे लगी है, ऐसे।
The doctors, the child is okay, but just speaks volumes of how the attacks are only increasing here. Remember, this comes in spite of so many warnings and so many precautions being taken in many parts of this particular area, where the forest department is at it when it comes to creating awareness, but the attacks from wolves continues unabated. With video journalist Sanjay and Ram Sneha Moldani in Behraj for India Today TV.